This video was developed by the Tennessee Integrated Food Safety Center of Excellence. This video will cover various ways to export a REDCap database, demonstrate how REDCap can automatically alert users, and how to archive a project when data collection has ended. It is important to note that REDCap data should be exported if extensive data analysis will be performed. Though REDCap is capable of completing some calculations, it is meant to be used as a data collection and management tool rather than a statistical analysis tool. Therefore, it is best to export the data in its raw form, then clean, manipulate, and analyze it using a separate program. REDCap data can be exported in the following formats: Excel, SPSS, SAS, R, STATA, and XML. The XML file can be uploaded into another REDCap project or instance to create a duplicate of the project shell and metadata. This can also be done under Other Export Options. Additional export options can be found in that tab as well. After selecting an export format, decide whether the data should include identifiers, freeform text, or date fields. You can choose these settings under the De-identification options in the middle of the Data Export pop-up box. More advanced settings are available on the right-hand side of the pop-up box. Click Export Data to export the data. It is not always necessary or ideal to export the entire database. Exported data can be limited to the conditions specified in a REDCap report. To create a report, click the link on the left-hand side of the screen titled Data Exports, Reports, and Stats. Once on this page, click Create New Report to open the page and customize the report. The following details are required to create a report: the report name, who can view and edit the report, and which fields should be included. First, name the report. Then, follow the four steps on the page to build a report. Step 1 determines which users can edit or view the report. Add the needed report fields in Step 2. There are several ways to go about doing this, such as typing in the variable name or field label, selecting individual fields from the dropdown, using the Quick Add option, which provides a list of fields to select, or choosing to add all fields at once from a specific instrument. Steps 3 and 4 are optional. In Step 3, users can add filters that only return data that fit the given logic statement. Step 3 also includes the option to apply live filters to the report, which can filter multiple choice fields, events, or data access groups in real time with REDCap. Step 4 allows users to order the results based on fields in either ascending or descending order. Once you have finished customizing the report, click Save Report. A message indicating the report has been saved and the option to view it will appear. Click View Report to see what data meets the conditions specified in the report. The data can be exported by clicking Export Data. When working with time-sensitive outbreak data, it may be important to be notified when data that meets specific criteria is entered into the database. REDCap can both trigger and schedule a customized email to one or more recipients when a form or survey is either saved or meets conditional logic. For example, users can set REDCap to automatically send an email alert to the outbreak investigation team when a case indicates they attended the same event as another sick individual. To set this up, click the Alerts and Notifications link on the screen's left side. The page will appear with an Add New Alert button. Click on this button to create and customize a new alert. Alerts are very customizable. Some customization options include determining what criteria will trigger the alert, setting how many times the alert will be sent, specifying the sender and recipient, drafting the message to be sent, and adding attachments to the email. Setting an automatic expiration will deactivate the alert at a specified date and time. Alerts can only be deactivated, as there is no option to delete them. Once the email alert has been created and customized, click Save. For an additional cost, a third-party application called Twilio can be enabled to send an alert by text or voice call. This service is integrated into REDCap and should only be set up by the administrator. Users can view alert activity by clicking the Notification Log tab or the View List link in the Activity box. When data analysis is complete for a REDCap project and is no longer being used, it is best practice to export a copy of the database, data dictionary, and codebook, saving and archiving them on a local or shared drive. The REDCap administrator can then mark the project as complete, or they can delete the project outright. If a project is marked complete, the data will remain within it. The administrator can restore it to active status at any time. The project will no longer appear on the user's My Projects page unless the Show Completed Projects option is clicked at the bottom of the project list. This concludes the video on exports, alerts, and archiving.